other franchise can match the magical aura of the New York Yankees. Their record of 27 World Championships is unmatched in any sport, and their power-packed lineup is as intimidating as ever. But this year, the Oakland Athletics aren't conceding anything to the umpire from the East. The 2012 A's have assembled another impressive array of young talent. These guys play hard every night.
It's always good to have young guys around. They have that passion. This is where they want to be. They want to be in the big leagues. And you can see that drive and that intensity coming from day in and day out. And I think that sparks it within you as well. It keeps you going, keeps you motivated, keeps you pushing.
Tonight, these two teams renew a rivalry that has been going strong for over 100 years. And the green and gold will have to be at their best. The A's take on the New York Yankees next. Tonight is the first of 10 matchups this season between the A's and the Yankees. And tonight should be a busy place. Authentic Fan Friday here at the Coliseum. Derek Jeter in town. He's having a terrific season. And it's that man's job to hold down the Yankees. Tyson Ross will make the start tonight for the Athletics. So the place is jumping. It's the first of a three-game series, the Yankees and the A's. You'll see it right here on Comcast Sportsnet, California. Hey, good everybody. Welcome to Oakland A's Baseball along with Ray Fossey. I'm Glenn Kuiper. Always exciting when the Yankees are in town, but they're just two games over 500. They're actually in fourth place in the AL East, Ray, but still very dangerous lineup. And again, they hit a lot of home runs.
Where do you want to start? Probably a lineup that you can look at and say 1 through 9. They can beat you with a home run. They can hit home runs as the Granny Man. Curtis Granderson coming up from the Tigers. Great job. He's always hitting home runs. Alex Rodriguez starting to get hot again. A couple of home runs 2 days ago. Of course, everybody up and down the lineup. Mark Teixeira, not really off to a great start, but he can hit home runs from the left side or the right side. And how about our good friend Nick Swisher with the Yankees? He's also a switch hitter. He's doing a great job. And the captain, there's no doubt, Derek Jeter is just a tremendous guy. But 1 through 9. They can beat you with a long ball. Tyson Ross can stop that.
Indeed, that's the challenge for Tyson Ross, Ray. When his ball sinks, he's good. Right. When it straightens out, he's not good. Let's hope he sinks it tonight.
Two games against the Angels in Anaheim. 23 ground ball outs total, and that's what he needs to do. Good news for him, he won here against Cleveland on his birthday. So he likes the mound here. He's changed his delivery a little bit. He's getting more ground ball outs. Also remember, he's got the split finger fastball. I think he's up for this game, especially in front of the big crowd.
All right, Tyson Ross will be opposed by Ivan Nova, who was a 16-game winner last year as a rookie. So there's your pitching matchup. Fireworks after the game. It is a huge crowd. Should be a fun night of baseball here at the Coliseum. It's the A's and the Yankees coming up on Comcast Sportsnet California. We'll have lineups and first pitch in just a moment.
California is brought to you by AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And by Toyota. Check out the great deals at your local Toyota dealer today.
And welcome back to the Coliseum. The A's just now taking the field, getting set to host the New York Yankees. Yankees will make two trips in this year, so the first of the two trips. So we're looking forward to a fun night and a fun weekend of baseball here at the Coliseum. A's and Yankees, the first of three. Game time weather brought to you by the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk. Get to the beach. The admission-free boardwalk is now open daily. 58 degrees, breezy. So indeed, a chilly night. A few clouds in the sky. It actually rained a little bit this afternoon. So maybe a little cooler than normal, but a nice night. Put a jacket on and enjoy the ball game.
Well, it's going to be probably a sellout crowd with the fireworks following the game. So it's always great to see a big crowd here and a immaculate field as always for Cozy Clay Wood.
Here's the lineup for the Yankees: Jeter, Granderson, A-Rod, Cano, Teixeira, Abania, Swisher, Eric Chavez, and Russell Martin. So that's the lineup for the New York Yankees.
Talk about a hot captain. Unbelievable. They last year said Derek Jeter's finished.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, really. It's amazing. Since his calf injury, coming back, getting his 3,000th hit, he's only hit about 360 since then. Unbelievable. But at 37, he just gets better with age.
Tyson Ross's first pitch is a swing and a miss.
First pitch.
A good, nasty, hard sinker down and in to Derek Jeter, who probably one of the best opposite field hitters. And all you have to do is look at the defense. You see the way the A's are playing him. He loves to hit the ball to right field.
It is a classic inside out swing.
Absolutely. You see the defense all lining up to the right side in the outfield, the infield. Almost kind of a reverse shift that you would see with a right handed hitter. Normally to the left side, but not for Jeter.
So 0-2 to Jeter. Granderson in the on deck circle. And pitch is a breaking ball outside. So Tyson Ross, Ivan Nova, the pitchers tonight. Yankees had an off day yesterday. They traveled to the Bay Area. The A's had an off day at home, which is nice. Jeter swing and a miss. He struck him out.
A good start for Tyson Ross. Finished Derek Jeter with a 94 mile an hour fastball. And boy, what a great job just watching his turn. And of course, coming off a tough start in San Francisco, but on the season, making his eighth start. As we mentioned, his win here against Cleveland. Also beat the Angels. Beat Cleveland on his birthday. But that ERA, a little bit elevated, but he is just a young man trying to get settled into a rotation. Just watch his windup. Watch as he winds up and then turns his back. A little bit of a pause before he delivers the ball.
Granderson on the first pitch lines it to left field for a base hit.
Derek Jeter swung at the first fastball he saw. Same for Curtis Granderson. Not surprising. An aggressive team. They know the strike zone.
Here's the defense for the A's tonight. Smith, Crisp, and Reddick in the outfield. Donaldson, Pennington, Weeks, and Barton on the infield. Kurt Suzuki behind the plate. So Alex Rodriguez steps in. So Ray, first two guys swing at their first pitch. It's only two batters, but could that be a scouting report right there that the Yankees have on Ross?
And he wants to get ahead. First pitch fastball. And of course, they are disciplined hitters, the Yankees are. To the point of if they get a first ball fastball, they're ready to swing at it, as Jeter did and Granderson. But it also means that Kurt Suzuki could call even a splitter, change up type, slider. And he did throw a fastball first pitch to Alex Rodriguez. They like to pitch him inside, usually what the A's have done.
Hits that one foul to our right. Last game for Alex Rodriguez Wednesday against the Royals in New York. He had a pair of home runs.
And he kind of called it before the game, said he figured out something in his swing and felt he's going to have a pretty good game. Well, I guess you could say not quite of the Babe Ruth type, but he said he's feeling better, and those two home runs proof of that. You do not want to see him get hot.
1-1 pitch is a shot right field. That's a base hit in front of Reddick. So Granderson to second, and Alex Rodriguez has a base hit. So two on one out here in the top of the first inning for the Yankees for Robinson Cano.
Another fastball, and he wanted it down. Suzuki wanted the pitch down, and they left it up to Alex, and he just took his base hit to the opposite field. Thing about a lineup like this, and we talk about it, and you know, you can talk payroll all you want. Bottom line is they try to get the best players, and 1 through 9, they've got a very good lineup, but there's no place that you can stop, catch a breath, and say, okay, this is easy. I mean, it's tough, 1 through 9, and for a pitcher to pitch well against the Yankees lineup over and over, 2 or 3, 4 times through the order, that's doing something because they're that good.
It's funny there. Two leading RBI men are Abanez and Swisher with 27 RBIs. They're hitting 6th and 7th.
You look at the Yankees payroll, you'll find Rob Abanez way down on the list. That was an offseason acquisition that's turned out great for them.
Cano bounces one, Barton on the backhand. Second for one, back to first, not in time. So Cano hustling down the line, keeps the inning alive.
Well, great play by Derek Barton. That ball looked like it's going to shoot past him, but able to catch it. And it's Brian Onora who thought Cano beat it. But Cano, high fastball. And the return throw by Cliff Pennington to Tyson Ross. Bang, bang. And it went to the runner. Tyson, a good job. Good athletic ability to get over quickly to take the throw from Pennington. And that's always a tough play because that ball gets by Ross at first base. It's a run with Granderson at third base.
So here's Teixeira. Two outs. Now runners on the corners. Teixeira off to a slow start. And he takes a first pitch strike.
Now Derek Barton really reaching down on a ball that looked like it's going to take off on him. So able to get the lead runner at second base. And Pennington making sure that Tyson Ross was at the bag at first. And one of his straight throws, easy, just to make sure that he was there.
That went foul territory. Donaldson on the move, and he makes the catch. Donaldson made the play in foul territory, and the Yankees do not score in the top of the first. How about this play, folks?
Outstanding, catches it, pops up on the mound, and kind of does a little backpedaling to the.
Now the Yankees strand a couple in the top of the first, and let's take a look at the Athletics lineup in the bottom of the first. Weeks, Chris Bredig, Smith, Kaihui, Donaldson, Barton, Suzuki, and Pennington. So Weeks steps in. Ivan Nova, the big right-hander's first pitch, outside corner strike to Weeks. 199 with 2 homers and 5 RBIs.
Coco Crisp waiting in the on deck circle. Alex Rodriguez in to share both in case of a bunt by Weeks. Well, this one fouled.
Ivan Nova, four game winner this season. The A's did not face him, would not face him. He won 16 last season. Just his second year with the Yankees. Outstanding starting pitch. They talk about all the big boys, but Nova, great year last year for the Yankees. And like Tyson Ross on the large size.
He was a rookie last year and he went 16-4.
Took another pitcher in Hellickson who won the rookie of the year.
And Hellickson had 13 wins, so Nova actually had three more wins than the rookie of the year Hellickson.
One of those guys, of course, Yankees acquired Pineda. Pineda's on the disabled list to add to the rotation.
So 2-2, close pitch. Weeks takes it. There's Joe Girardi.
Couple of former catchers, Girardi, of course, the manager, Tony Pena's bench coach, former manager as well with Kansas City, now Girardi's bench coach. Both Shannon and Lecter managers. Huh? Joe's a good one, though, no doubt. Very good catcher in his own right, but Danny Cone's perfect game. So, how would you like to have been a teammate of the captain, Derek Jeter, and then now you're managing? That's exactly what Joe Girardi's doing.
So full count to Weeks and the pitch. Followed again. The Yankees last year won the American League East, winning 97 games. So they had the best record in the American League. But they lost in the division series to the Tigers 3-2. They had the second best record in the major leagues. Only the Phillies were better. So great regular season, very disappointing postseason for the Yankees.
See that one guy standing there? His name is Andy Pettit. He moves out of baseball. He retired before last season, and he is back. There's Pettit, Danny Hector, Larry Rothschild. He's made three starts and with that already a couple of wins and pitching great. Eight innings, the last start. It's a nice addition to a rotation.
Yeah, just plug him in.
Doing a good job as a leadoff hitter. Of course, ninth pitch coming up. Trying to see all of them from Nova.
Bounce at home plate. So the A's and the Yankees. These two teams will play 10 times this year, 7 times here in Oakland, just 3 in New York. And the A's trip to New York isn't until the end of the year, mid-September. Will come back here middle of July for a 4-game series. That one bounced up the middle into center field, a base hit. So Weeks is aboard with the leadoff single. Let's look at the Yankees defense for tonight behind Ivan Nova. Abanez, Granderson, and Swisher in the outfield. Rodriguez, Jeter, Cano, and Teixeira in the infield with Russell Martin doing the catching.
I hope Jamal Weeks likes Francesco's because he's going to be visiting there with a 10-pitch at bat. What a great at bat by the A's leadoff hitter, Jamal Weeks. 10 pitches. So, Chad Davis have a nice certificate for him for Francesco's, but that's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches, a lot of different pitches from Nova, who will throw all four: fastball, curveball, slider, and changeup.
First pitch to Coco Crisp is a bit outside. Coco hitting 175 with no homers and 5 RBIs.
Russell Martin gets a little upset with that first curveball. He's walking slowly, looking back toward the dugout, and back to the home plate umpire, Corey Blazer. And then actually walked the baseball out, just handed it to Nova and walking back.
He evidently was,
and I don't know, it looked like the curveball came around the plate. Nova has not thrown a sharp breaking ball yet. Now there's a little discussion. That's Russell Martin, the veteran, doing what you're supposed to. You make your comments with your back to the umpire.
So 1-0 the count. No. But is walking the ball all the way out necessary? I mean,
I'm not trying
to be a smart aleck. I mean, I'm asking you. You were kind of, I mean, I don't know. Is it you trying to make a point early?
Yeah, he definitely was trying to make a point. I think he did. And again, you could see Blazer, his head moving a little bit. So there's a conversation going on. But again, Russell, I've very rarely seen a pitcher or a catcher walk the ball to the pitcher. And he just walked out, handed the ball, walked back, and a couple of comments.
Yeah, it was the, you know, the 10th pitch of the night for Nova.
But Russell was trying to establish the curveball. Nova has a good one. 2-4 seam fastball, so curveball an important pitch for him. And it's a kind of a 12-6, so it's one of those that's always tough for a pitcher to throw consistently and get strikes.
Coco shows bunt. It's outside, 2-1.
As we always remember Barry Zito, his 12-6 curveball that guys would take, guys wouldn't swing at it.
Good lead as always. Not running. And Coco hits one right toward Jeter. He's near the bag. He'll take it himself. And that's a double play. So Jeter was shaded right near the bag, and the ball was hit right to him. 6-3 double play.
Another ground ball, but unfortunately, is this ball a little bit away from Coco, right to Derek Jeter. And even though Cano is there, he took it himself, which he should have because he was that close to the bag. Ball hit too hard for any thought of Coco beating out and avoiding a double play. So 10 pitches to Jamile, 4 pitches to Coco, and that quickly 2 outs.
Here's Reddick, who takes just a bit low. Nova 95 miles an hour, throws pretty hard. Big overhand curve, and there's the one Ray's talking about. Drops in, and he likes to throw it. It's a pitch that he can throw for a strike, even though it's got a lot of break. 24% of his pitches are curveballs, and that's a lot.
And I think that's why Russell Martin did what he did, trying to make sure the umpire knows of that type of curveball.
So the A's get a leadoff single, but the double play ends it. So we are through one from the Coliseum. No score, A's and the Yankees.
The Yankees in town, of course, for the second game of the series. 1:05 p.m. first pitch. Pet adoption day. 10,000 fans will receive an A's pet calendar. It's always a good one. It's courtesy of Central Garden and Pet. For tickets, go to OaklandAthletics.com or 877-493-BALL. It's tomorrow. We're at the Coliseum Game 2 of the weekend series.
Just part of a very busy weekend at the ballpark. tonight. Of course, fireworks coming up after the game. Authentic Fan Friday just above us. Probably packed up there.
Probably, no doubt. Should be, as the whole place is going to be packed.
Raul Ibanez takes a strike, so it's 0-2 to Ibanez, followed by Swisher and then Eric Chavez.
What a story for this young man. Young man at 39, Raul Ibanez, scores Phillies, and kind of late sign by the Yankees, and what a deal. What a season he is having. 9 home runs, 27 driven in. Remember last year with Brandon Allen in a third deck shot? Only three guys have gone third deck at Yankee Stadium, the new one. Russell Branyan, Brandon Allen last year, Raul Ibanez this year. So he is joined the few who have gone very deep at Yankee Stadium. Brandon Allen might be fighting tonight.
Yeah. Red Sox and the Rays are going at it in more ways than one at Fenway Park. Rays with a 7-4 lead over the Red Sox in the ninth inning. Dugouts emptied, and there's a lot of unhappy ball players and coaches. 1-2 pitch on his big chopper. Shift was on, so Pennington has to range far to his right, go on the other side of second base. Makes the play.
But Bartolo Colon pitching tomorrow. He's with the Yankees last year, and watch Brandon Allen this shot. His first major league home run. Colon didn't even look at it. He said, just give me another ball. We've seen that for Bartolo, but that shot by Brandon Allen, the first of two. And Hector Nueci also, but what a shot off of that man who is now the green and gold and getting ready to face the Yankees, his former team tomorrow, and CC Sabathia Vallejo on the mound for the Yankees.
So here's Nick Swisher. Swisher 7 home runs, 27 RBIs. Average down a little bit, 236.
Of course, Swisher's off to a great start. Got a little hamstring issue, and he said ever since he's come back from that injury, he can't buy a hit. Well, he is pumped, as he said, happy to get out of New York, get some fresh air in California. Played well for the Athletics.
This one down the left field line into the corner, and it drops fair. So Swisher digging for second, and he'll have a sliding one out double. So it was really just a high fly ball. He hit it fairly well, but it landed about 2 feet fair.
And of course, as far away as Seth Smith was, plenty more to pull, and kind of an inside out swing, and this would not slice foul. As he kind of waited to see where the ball was. It's one of those swings, and maybe trying to pull the ball, as it turned out, ended up going opposite field.
So that's the third hit in the game for the Yankees, and here's Eric Chavez. Chavez is the DH tonight. He takes a breaking ball for a strike.
The A's fans like the two guys. Nick Swisher at second, Eric Chavez hitting, but they don't like them so much now that they're in the traditional Yankee road Rays.
A 1 pitch just missed inside. 293 for Chavez, 3 homers, 6 RBIs. Bounces it, big hop for Barton, and he'll flip to Ross, and that's out number two with Swisher going to third.
Well, Nick Swisher with the Athletics came up with the system and played well, no doubt. This is when his father Steve Swisher came in, and Swisher had donated his hair for a charity, and Swisher could play. And the old saying goes, he and Milton Bradley, it seemed like every time Swisher hit a home run, Bradley would also, and Frank Thomas. And tell you what, he may talk a lot, but he can walk and talk, man. He can play. And he had some great seasons with the Athletics, very energetic, and he's taken that energy to the White Sox for a year, and now Yankee.
pitch to Russell Martin. Breaking ball, first strike. Swisher 4 years with the A's, and then of course traded to the White Sox 1 year in Chicago, where really that was probably the worst year of his career. Then he got traded to the Yankees, and now his fourth year in New York, and I think he likes it. Close pitch, 1-1.
A big out on Teixeira in the first inning. Great play by Josh Donaldson with a couple of runners on base, one in scoring position, actually first and third, and we have it again, a runner, third and two out. So Tyson Ross, early trouble, so he can get out of another jam.
Fastball outside, 2-1 to Martin, hitting 173, 4 homers, 10 RBIs. Crowd tonight, maybe a sellout or maybe close to a sellout. Three and one now to Martin with Jeter in the on deck circle.
A couple of sliders that Martin has not offered at, and so far 3-1 on Russell Martin, the ninth place hitter, and Derek Jeter leading off in the on deck circle. Challenge fastball, how good this one will be if he does throw a fastball.
Barton into foul territory, and he's got it, side retired. So another runner stranded for the Yankees. We head to the bottom of the second, no score. Our Ford Wright choice, and with that we're keeping you updated on Manny Ramirez. He's in the lineup tonight, and he's got a base hit, singled in the very first inning for the River Cats, and that's a home game, so River Cats in Sacramento. So Manny Ramirez in the lineup. We're also told Brandon Inge is in the lineup as well for Sacramento, batting second, so that's good news.
He's supposed to play tonight, tomorrow, and hope that he is going to be on the flight Sunday when the A's head to Minneapolis.
Well, wouldn't that be?
Start getting them back.
Yeah, just a little bit sure. Seth Smith leading it off. Shoots one foul, so it's 0-2. So we'll keep you updated on Manny Ramirez tonight and Brandon Inge as they're both playing for the River Cats. Probably got a nice big crowd up there in Sacramento with Manny Ramirez in town.
Well, everybody's looking at the May 30th. That's his first day of eligibility. And I think everybody maybe expecting him to join the Athletics. And, you know, it's not easy. I think Chili Davis said it best. When you miss an entire season, as Manny did,
That would hit hard to right, but Swisher tracks it down.
But it's not easy, first of all, to miss time, even as a young age, at a young age, but be 39 turning 40 on the day that you're eligible.
Batting in the fifth position.
I mean, granted, some guys can fall out of bed and hit. Those are good games, but Chilla Davis knows from experience that the older you get, the harder it is to come back. I'm sure as much as Bob Melvin would like to have some offense, he hopes to get it, and but get Manny Ramirez, if that's the case, at a time when he's ready to play and ready to contribute.
First pitch to Kaiahue is outside. Well, Manny had less than 20 at bats last year with the Rays, so you're right, really, that you could almost say he didn't play at all last year.
You'd have to go back to 2010 by missing as much as he did.
One for 17 last year.
Guys staying around. Andrew Jones, just amazing career he had as a youngster and still going strong.
Off speed pitch from Nolan, a good one. So the count 0-2 to Kaiahue.
I know. Should I take my glasses off?
Mustache giveaways, cheer cards, t-shirts. All upstairs. Value deck. And an overhand curve and a good one. And that's strikeout number one for Nova. All right, here's tonight's Home Depot doing more on defense. Remember these plays? That was the best one right there. From the seat of his pants, made a nice play. And he's got one tonight.
Well, he's got a great arm, and definitely tonight. Never know what Mark Teixeira would have done with another chance, but Donaldson took it away. Hit a golf ball too, as the group playing in front of him found out yesterday.
I was playing behind him. You were in front of him?
No, I wasn't. I was told about him from the group that played in front of him.
Yeah,
and said he didn't bother to let them get on the green. That was dangerous. Great course, luck. Going on yesterday. Good day at Round Hook Country Club, Alamo. Tonight, this is probably the top. First and third, Mark Teixeira at the plate. Donaldson in a big foul territory. Caught it to hit the mound. Came close to the mound. Popped up. Did a moonwalk back to the dugout. That was an outstanding play. And of course, knowing the foul territory here, Eric Chavez knows as he's now with the Yankees. But boy, if you're not familiar, that familiar with it.
Swing and a miss. He ran the fastball up and in. So a three up, three down inning for Nova. Couple of strikeouts. So we're through two at the Coliseum. No score. A's and Yanks. quote, I think we're an underdog, period, and I think we probably relish that. We're certainly not scared of them. That's the manager, Bob Melvin. I'm playing the Yankees.
I don't think Bob Melvin's afraid of playing anybody. He is into every game, and actually two very good managers, two former catchers managing the respective teams, Joe Girardi, the Yankees, Bob Melvin, the Athletics, of course, and both good ones.
So Jeter to lead it off, followed by Granderson and Rodriguez. First pitch, ball for strike from Tyson Woods. The Yankees won the World Series in 2009, but before that, you got to go back to 2000. So, one World Series in 11 years, right?
For over $1 billion.
There's a lot of teams that would take one World Series every 11 years. I'm not saying that that's bad.
Like the Cubs would?
Yeah. Jeter shoots that one foul.
Well, a former Athletic, of course, is number retired, number 9 here. And Corworth, 44 in New York. Of course, Reggie Jackson, he is and was in uniform tonight and works for the Yankees. He's here, of course, with the Yankees in town. Reggie out during batting practice for the Yankees.
And Jeter goes around and he knew it. So Jeter has struck out twice in the game. That's out number 1.
Getting a hard down and in, and Jeter started his swing, got the hard sinker, and it was called by Corey Blaze of the home plate umpire, and that might have had the plate anyway.
Number 14.
Maybe that's what it was called about, because I don't think he swung. Now there's your fastball and slider, pretty much two pitches, and then the change, which is a split finger fastball for his change. A nice pitch that he has added. I think the biggest thing, Cap, is the way he turns, especially out of the windup. We just saw Dan Heron, or actually the Angels in town, didn't see him in the series, but as he turns his shoulder, it's something new that he started with Kurt Young, but he kind of pauses a little bit. Dan Heron will actually pause for about a second. See the turn and the pause gets him set up to be able to throw the ball a lot more effectively. Watch the turn as he goes the windup. He still has a short stride, but the turn there kind of pauses on his right foot, balances himself, and then pushes off with the right foot. And something that Kurt Young picked up, worked with him, and just trying to change to get him more consistently in the strike zone, especially down in the zone, to get the ground ball out. Kurt Young is so good.
He's been good his last two starts. Of course, the 6 shutout innings down in Anaheim, and then his last start, even though he took the loss in San Francisco, he did pitch well that day. The only drawback, he walked 4. Saw Reggie Jackson signing autographs before the game.
And Reggie is throwing not very well because he had a shoulder replacement. Left shoulder replacement. That was November the 1st. So he is making a comeback. So it's always good to see Mr. October.
Oh, he looks like he's in good shape.
He's always kept himself in good shape. And Joe Girardi had his bag, of course, number 9 worn here and then 44 with New York. But Reggie had his bag there, walked in, a couple of gloves. Times BP. Let's go.
Left center field, another hit for Granderson. He's 2 for 2, both hits to left field. All right, here's our true story brought to you by McDonald's. Alex Rodriguez, how many career home runs does he have against the Oakland A's? How about 43, tied with Rafael Palmeiro? That's a lot. So 636 in his career and 43 against the Athletics. And of course, for the majority of first part of his career, he was in the same division as the Athletics, so he faced them a lot.
And you notice the only other active and soon to be active still playing, that would be Manny Ramirez on that list as well. He's going to be a member of the Athletics eventually.
Well, we don't want Manny to hit any more home runs against
no,
the A's.
No.
That's not the plan anymore.
Hit him for the A's.
Rodriguez had a base hit in the first inning.
Well, two guys on the Yankees that wore the number 3 with the other teams that they played on. Alex Rodriguez, of course, Mariners, Texas, and Eric Chavez with the A's. Chavez wearing 12, 1 plus 2. And Alex Rodriguez has a 3 in his number 13. I don't think Babe Ruth's number is going to come off of the retired number list
in
Yankee
it.
Stadium.
I doubt
it. See, Babe Ruth, that jersey had 3, and Ruth, Babe Ruth didn't have his name on his jersey.
No.
Yankees don't have their names on their jerseys. Home or away. Souvenir jerseys, yes.
Now, Jackie Robinson, for very good reasons, has his jersey retired by every team.
A slider, for some reason, Alex didn't like the call. Maybe thought it was too high. But think about Alex Rodriguez. Stay hard. Everything hard.
You get
iron hopes.
Swing and a miss. So Alex Rodriguez strikes out. That's the third strikeout for Hyson Ross.
Well, he goes back to that hard sinker down and in. And Alex Rodriguez, no contact, pitch out of the strike zone.
Number 24, Robinson Cano.
So here's Robinson Cano.
That is a very, very good pitcher's pitch. Especially with the movement that Tyson Ross has on his fastball tonight.
Cano reached out a fielder's choice in the first. So my point was, so Jackie Robinson, for all the right reasons, because he's retired, but if you could probably make a point that if there was another player in Major League Baseball history to have his number retired, it would probably be Babe Ruth. Would you agree with that?
And yes.
I mean, I'm talking the history of baseball, influence, what he did for the game.
There's been talk about Roberto Clemente, number 21, but I agree. Babe Ruth, I mean, when you build a house.
Well, it's just, I mean, he is. His name is baseball. And Roberto Clemente for the Latin players.
Exactly.
And that would make a lot of sense.
Right. And that's the reason that there have been some who said that should be retired permanently, like Jackie Robinson. And only Mariano Rivera is wearing the number 42. And coincidentally, Robinson Cano is wearing 24. The opposite turnaround, of course, named after the late Jackie Robinson.
Way inside. The Yankees got all kinds of numbers retired.
Now check this. You got number 8 twice.
Yeah.
Bill Dickey and Yogi Berra.
So 2 and 6 are sitting out there. Jeter has it, and we've speculated about Joe Torre.
Exactly.
Who wore number 6. Think about what he did for the Yankees franchise.
Probably not in our lifetime, but there will be a day wearing number 101 for the New York Yankees.
101, and we're not talking about the freeway.
Because of the number of retired numbers, of course, Derek's number 2 will be eventually retired. Once he ever, if he ever retires, I hope he does it.
That one's lined right center field. Coco Crisp on the move, and it goes over his glove and all the way to the wall. Here comes Granderson around third. He will score. Cano stops at second, and the Yankees lead 1-0. Well, Coco had a beat on it.
Unless it just took off on him, it was a ball that he was there. And Robinson Cano, he's got a strong swing, but the thing is, Coco, with his speed, got to the ball and off his glove. So he got to it and just missed it as he put up his glove. And he closed the glove and looked like it hit him right on the side of him.
So the Yankees jump on top. So they're going to give Coco Crisp an error. So Cano will not get an RBI.
Well,
0-1 to Teixeira, who fouled out. Nice play by Donaldson to end the first inning. That happened with a couple of runners on. Shift is on. Way outside. So 1-1 the count to Teixeira. You know, all those retired numbers, though, Ray, and they have a lot of them. You can't argue with any of them. They all are legit, should be legitimately retired. So 2-1 now to Teixeira. Ross has to dig down after the defensive mistake by Coco Crisp.
Now Tyson Ross, as any pitcher knows, that it's a mistake made behind and should be back in the dugout, but a time that bear down a little bit harder. Try to get the third out and get back to the inning and minimize the damage.
That one's drilled to right, and that's deep. Reddick going back, and it is gone. Landed right on top of the out-of-town scoreboard to Teixeira homers, and it's 3-0.
Thing about Teixeira, he is very strong. He keeps his bat back. It's an off-speed pitch, and you could just see the way he reacted on the pitch. Watch his body. He gets out in front. Look at that. That's a one-handed swing. He's full, extended, and that's how strong of a player he is. And a good mistake hitter. And we have seen that all too often here, where he has got a mistake, especially with the off-speed pitch, and done exactly that.
Eddington backhands, and that goes under his glove into center field. Phil Banez is aboard. See what the ruling is on that play. It was going to be a tough play for Pennington.
Now this is at 88 miles per hour.
And 33.
Again, there's no doubt that Mark Teixeira, it's a, you know, the fastball, he could not get around on a fastball his first at bat. And the count was 0-1. And Cliff with the shift. He's playing on the first base side of second. Fielded the ball to the right side by Banez in his first at bat. This time, it's got to be a tough play because Banez gets down the line very well. And even had he backhanded the ball clearly and cleanly, that it's going to be tough to throw him out.
So it goes as a base hit for Banez. The breakdown this year for Ross, 389 is what left-handed hitters are hitting against him. Tonight, Granderson with two hits. Teixeira with the home run, Banez with a hit, Swisher with a double. And Swisher steps in. His double was down the left field line. How about the decision for the Yankees, Ray? Do they re-sign Nick Swisher? He's a free agent.
I'd say yes. I'd say that they will try their best to sign him, because Joe Girardi knows that he can play first. He can play the outfield. Switch hitter.
This one's sky, and it's heading for the seats. Of course, Mariano Rivera, who's out for the year, is will also be a free agent. He said he'd like to come back. But Swisher's been extremely productive with the Yankees. Helped him win the World Series in 2009. But you're right, the versatility, and he's pretty good at all those positions that he plays.
Gene Michael, of course, longtime shortstop and manager, general manager, the Yankees scout, he said, we like to sign left-handed hitters. So we don't want right-handers unless they can hit the ball a long way or go to the outside field. But left-handed hitters with Yankee Stadium dimensions is the type of hitter they are always looking for. And Nick Swisher, of course, has proven that with his home run production throughout his career. And Alex Rodriguez can hit him anyway.
Swisher takes high, so 2-1. Russell Martin, the catcher, a free agent. Some of their pitchers, Carota, some of the veterans, Freddie Garcia, they'll all be free agents. But Swisher will be a key offensive play.
I think it's humorous that they're always talking about the Yankees trying to get the payroll down to get under the major league threshold for luxury tax. Forget it. Just won't happen.
Two and two to Swisher. Bañez takes off, and this one's hit high to center field. Chris to his right. He's got it side to tie. So three runs for the Yankees, a costly error by the A's. 3-0 New York as we head to the bottom of the third. Brought to you by Cache Creek Casino Resort. Swing away for big league cash only at Cache Creek. Visit CacheCreek.com for details. Nice look at the Coliseum. The big crowd. 3-0 Yankees. It's the bottom of the third. Now Tyson Ross thought he was out of the inning, but Coco Crisp could not handle the fly ball, and that would have been the third out, so it cost the A's three runs.
Yeah. And yes, you can look on the and see the unearned, but the problem in you know, pitching is very important. But as far as the A's are concerned, they're just not getting a lot of hits, scoring a lot of runs. So anytime you see a mistake happen and you see the team get down, it's an uphill battle to just try to make up for it.
Well, when you're not scoring runs, you just cannot make mistakes defensively. Unfortunately, that's what happened. 1-1 to Barton. He'll be followed by Suzuki and Pennington. Not so good with the shutdown innings of Nova. He's got an opportunity here.
That's a pitch that is. And again, you can see Russell Martin in the first inning calling the curveball. One they didn't like and let Corey Blazer know, but you can see why the pitch is so important for Nova and for Russell Martin to call it, because it is a very good 12-inch curveball.
That one, he looked like he threw a little bit harder. Barton hitting 198 with a homer and four RBIs. Nova is a big guy. He's 6'4", 225 pounds. He's 25 years old. The Yankees signed him at a very young age. He was a undrafted free agent. They signed him when he was 17 years old out of the Dominican Republic. So you see that a lot where team sign Latin players at a very young age. It takes them a while to develop because they are so young when they enter professional baseball. But when they do get there, they've played a lot of professional baseball, which is it's a good thing.
All right, Rothschild, former manager of the Tampa Bay Rays, alongside Joe Girardi. It's Joe's pitching coach.
Another foul ball by Barton.
One thing they might not be liking right now, the number of foul balls with two strikes. That is the seventh. Four with Jamal Wicks, a 10-pitch at bat, and now three to Derek Barton. 38th season for Larry Rothschild.
Barton, a big chopper. Rodriguez waits for the good hop, flips it across, and that's out number one. So that'll bring up Kurt Suzuki.
Batting in the eighth position, number eight, the catcher, Kurt Suzuki.
Said it rained a little bit. See, when I left my house to come to work, it was raining.
Yep.
It turned out to be nice.
Supposed to be a beautiful weekend and into next week. Nice weather, so tickets are available for tomorrow and Sunday. And with the great weather and the Yankees in town, the final two games on the homestand, opportunity to come out and enjoy day baseball.
Suzuki just got under it. And Abanias takes care of it. That's out number two.
Now the second issue is now available for the A's magazine, and it features Brandon McCarthy and Bartolo Colon. You also get to know about Chili Davis and his great job as a hitting coach, and not cooking with Cliff Pennington.
Like
that, he and Missy, his wife, breaking down batting practice basics, also as part of the magazine. Available at team stores or OaklandAthletics.com/magazine. Nice publication, as always. To know about Cliff Pennington's cooking. That's
I would too.
Impressive. You can sample it and cook it and sample it, and we'll be happy to sample
Texas,
it.
Right?
Yeah, of course. Cliff Pennington, along with Kurt Suzuki and Scott Sizemore, coming out to the A's golf tournament last night. Short Q&A for the folks who participated. They didn't play in the golf tournament, but did come out for the evening.
Did you have fun yesterday?
Nice day.
Did you guys win again?
Of course. I mean, yes, we did.
Are you serious? Oh, gee.
Well, I tell you, come on. Now, you know, you get a good group of guys.
Sandbaggers. No, they win every year. Every
these
year
guys
they
are good. Keith Simmons. I mean, just again, Simmons drives the ball. You know that.
I saw the longest
Bobby
drive.
Jones,
was it 295
Jones.
Yards?
Yeah,
Keith Simmons?
Jones? Yeah, I mean, these guys can play good. They play every day.
I'm not.
Keith, of course, State Roofing System, big sponsor of the Athletics, so it's nice to let him win every once in a while. I just happen to be playing with the right group.
All right, all right.
But I, you know, one thing I am very impressed with you, because there was a short par four, and got up there and they said, "Is it close?" They said, "Glenn was closer." I said, "Who?"
Yeah,
Glenn Kuiper.
So, par three. He was a par three.
Of course, I've won. Yeah. We went straight down.
Yeah. Did I hold on to win the closest to the pin?
No. No. I would have told you if you did, but no, you didn't. That's hardly impressive. You were in the
that's
top.
That's what happens. That was our first hole. So if you could be closest to the pin in the first hole, it's not going to last. It's just not going to last.
But you were were mentioned.
It's good.
You were in the top. Whatever.
That was close. So you guys won again, huh?
Well, I missed it last year, so. Rejoin the group and
see what happens. You're the lucky charm. I played with a group of very nice gentlemen from Chevron.
That's great.
And they were great. We had fun. I had fun. We laughed a lot.
Chevron Group was a major sponsor. They gave Chevron gift cards for the prizes, one of which for the closest to the hole that you didn't win.
Could have got a gas card.
That's right. That was a good day.
It was fun.
Yeah, community
Round fun. Hill Country Club, beautiful.
30th anniversary. It's the 30th anniversary of the A's Community Fund Golf Tournament. Started in 1982. Left the Haas family, of course. So, nice turnout. Beautiful golf course, and I think all the houses and windows were protected or saved throughout the day.
For the most part.
Well, the A's have to try to find a way. They already have a hit, so that's. But it's only there's only one. Remember, the only one hit against the Giants on Saturday, and C.J. Wilson and the Angels Tuesday. So they need to try to put together some hits and score some runs.
I got to tell you though, one disappointment about the golf tournament. We started on the seventh hole, and guess where the Ruth Crisp sliders were?
Oh. On the eighth or the seventh?
Sixth.
Oh, the seventh. No, those were good.
And the last hole, I waited all day for a slider.
Those were good. They were great as a matter of fact.
Thank you. That one hit the left. Abanez gets back. Side retired.
You could have gone in reverse.
Ray Fosse wins the golf tournament again.
Away from the Bay Area and can't watch the A's on Comcast Sportsnet California, you can take them with you with MLB.tv. From out of market, every game is available online on your favorite device in HD quality. That's really special. Visit OaklandAthletics.com to order MLB.tv. Baseball everywhere. You got it? Enjoy it? Always use it.
Chavez, Martin, and Jeter. For the Yankees here in the top of the fourth inning. Yankees got three in the third for their 3-0 lead.
Well, Tyson's got to be a good pitcher and become a long man right now and just hold the Yankees down. See if this club can come back. Brandon Inge was so special for the Athletics when he first joined the club. 2 3-run home runs, 2 grand slams. Got kind of spoiled with the offensive production from Brandon Inge alone. So it'd be good to get him back active, and hopefully that is the case.
If you're just joining us, we talked about it a little bit earlier that both Manny Ramirez and Brandon Inge in the lineup tonight for the Sacramento RiverCats. So we're all looking forward to the time when Inge gets back, Cespedes gets back, and Manny Ramirez joins the team. And hope.
Three powerful hitters right there if they're on, which they are capable.
3-1 pitch is inside, a leadoff walk to Eric Chavez. Here's tonight's AT&T U-verse reverse replay. Remember these plays, right? Eric Chavez. Boy, what a terrific third baseman he was for the Athletics. 6-time Gold Glove winner. 6 consecutive seasons. He was terrific. It's still amazing when you hear him tell the story about when he first came up. He was not very confident playing third base.
He prayed that the ball would not be hit to him. That's simplified right there.
That's to right, and that's trouble. That's going to go to the wall. It bounces off the wall. Derek Chavez will get to third and he will put on the brakes. So the Yankees are right back at it. Second and third, nobody out.
Now Russell Martin with the double, of course, last at bat. His first one, the runner at third, popped up on a 3-1 fastball. This time got another fastball and maybe looked for it and thought about the opposite field, which he did very well, going to right field. So that quickly, a walk, and now a double, second and third, nobody out. Top the batting order.
So Jeter steps in, infield has to come in. Jeter has struck out twice, both times swinging. First pitch is swung on and fouled back. Jeter chased a pitch that was out of the strike zone.
Well, always a challenge for a pitcher with the infield in, knowing that they're already down 3-0. A couple of guys in scoring position.
Jeter takes inside. The career hit total for Derek Jeter right now, 3,152. He's two behind George Brett, so he's 15th all time, closing in on number 14, George Brett. 3,152. That one jammed, looped foul.
That's pretty impressive when the Yankees PR department puts out a list that starts showing milestones ready to be taken, and Jeter, of course, in that category.
Well, let's see. So he'll get to Brett.
He's tied with Paul Wehner right now at 3,152. So you're right, Brett.
Get to Cal Ripken. There's a way he could get to him. So he could get into the top 10 maybe if he stays healthy this year.
And as long as Derek Jeter has played since 1996, and he gets better with age, maybe the all-time hit record might be in jeopardy.
Maybe. Two and two the count. Ross needs a strikeout or a pop-up. And Barton into foul territory makes the catch. So Ross makes a good pitch, gets right in on the hands of Jeter.
Oh, that is really, really big. Staying inside, Jeter, of course, as we talked about, it's great opposite field swing, but in on the hands, just trying to protect. And Derek Barton playing in, he was not holding a runner, obviously, at second and third, but still, the ball in the vicinity is able to get to it quickly without territory. This guy might not be a bad one to walk. Curtis Granderson, then he faced Alex Rodriguez. So pick your poison.
Well, it almost makes you just say, you know what, just go after Granderson.
That's right.
Try to get a strikeout or something.
That's all you can do.
Granderson takes a bit inside. Two for two tonight for Granderson. Both singles to left field that he scored a run in the third.
One thing it does allow you to do, such a tough hitter Granderson is, to pitch him carefully without intentionally walking. You do not want to help the on deck hitter, in this case Alex Rodriguez. I always think if you're intentionally walking out, the guy in the on deck is going to be a little bit more motivated to try to do something. So you try to get him to hit your pitch. In case of Granderson, he's gone to the opposite field twice. The singles to left and left center.
The infield not all the way in now. And that went way inside, so 3-0. That's the inside of Curtis Granderson's hat. Be aggressive. Don't think. Have fun. Go, go, go.
Let's see. That would be Bartolo Colon.
That's pretty good, though.
That is great.
Think about it.
Yep. That's what the game is about. That's what it's all about.
So bases loaded for Alex Rodriguez. He has 22 career grand slams. This is his last one, and it was last April.
And that's when he had just come back. And I think that that was a game of which they thought he'd already struck out. Everybody thought he'd struck out. I think even he himself thought he'd struck out and ended up hitting a grand slam. Don't give him too many extra chances, because the A's now can play back for a ground ball, possible double play.
First pitch to Rodriguez. And he swings at a ball and just got a piece of it. So 22 career grand slams, one behind the all-time leader, Lou Gehrig. Manny Ramirez on that list as well.
He hits, he hit a lot of home runs, 500, 600. I figure he's going to come up at times with the bases loaded, and he had a chance.
So 0-1 the count. Chavez at third, Martin at second, Granderson at first. Breaking ball snaps in for a strike, and it's 0-2. It hung a little bit, but Rodriguez did not swing at it.
I wouldn't hang another one. Maybe go to that hard two-seamer down and in. Maybe try to get into chase. Kurt Suzuki in the first pitch put his glove on the ground, and that's exactly where Tyson threw it. Alex Rodriguez, an excellent mistake hitter.
0-2 pitch, and that one probably got a little bit too much of the plate, but had pretty good sink to it.
That man knows this is a big inning. Big hitter. Try to keep the Yankees at the three spot.
Long look by Ross. Now he's ready. That one hit on the ground. Pennington has it. They'll get the out at second. Throw to first. Double play. So Tyson Ross does the job. Keeps the Yankees off the board in the fourth. Bottom of the fourth. Coming up 3-0 New York. Question: who are the only three players since 1900 to play shortstop in the majors at the age of 18? I know one of them. Robin Young.
Personally? Absolutely.
Well, no, not personally, but I'm like 99% sure that Robin Young is. I know he was 18 with the Brewers. You like that guess?
I know he wore number 19. And that's the only thing that makes me think. Yeah. Yeah. Because I want to say he came up and he wore his number when he's 19.
Okay.
But
right. That's,
but that may have been a full year. So he could have come up when he's 18, maybe in September.
All right,
so
how about this thing? Alfredo Griffin. Remember when he came up with the Indians?
Oh, yeah.
And he was very young. We're just guessing. Then again, we're playing the Yankees, so the answer could have a Yankee in there somewhere. Coco hits it hard, but it stays up. Granderson has it.
Well, Alex Rodriguez, you figure he's a big home run hitter, but Tyson Ross made another very good pitch. Hard slider down and away, and Alex tried to pull it, and they Taylor made 6-4-3 double play. It was not at all out full intentional walk to Curtis Granderson, but they fell behind 3-0, then put him on base, and Tyson made the pitch to get that double play to get out of the inning.
So one out for Reddick. He's one hit so far. That was a leadoff single by Weeks. The other base runner was Pennington's walk last inning. The Angels and the Mariners are underway. Fourth inning in Seattle. Mariners 2, Angels nothing. That's the second game of a four-game series. Angels won last night 3-0. Reddick skies one to right. Swisher's going back. He's at the wall looking up, and that baby is gone. Reddick homers, and the A's are on the board.
I'll have a month, Josh Reddick. And now we talked about his ability to hit that certain pitch with an uppercut swing, and he just did it again. Watch the pitch from Nova and watch the swing.
Boy, that is dropping right into his hit zone.
Exactly. That is a beautiful swing.
So home run number 12. 8 of those have come in the month of May. Smith grounds out. So 8 home runs, 16 RBIs in 21 games in May for Reddick.
Well, he's got that nice little lift, little uppercut swing. Brought the leg back, planted the front foot, and dropped the head. Nice night. Ball carrying nicely.
Watch the catch. Reach. Make the throw ahead a bit.
Right near the Yankee side.
So two outs now here in the bottom of the fourth, and Kaiahue steps in. That one hit down the left field line. Abania is a long run into foul territory, and he reaches out and he made the catch. It's a nice play by Raul Abania, is right in front of the seats. Reddick's home run has the A's on the board. It's 3-1 New York after four. trivia. Answer: who are the only three players since 1900 to play shortstop in the major leagues at the age of 18? Alex Rodriguez with Seattle, Robin Yount with Milwaukee, and Tony La Russa with the Kansas City A's in 1963.
That's right. That was a time when if you were a top selection, they didn't have the draft until 1965, but if you were signed, they call them the bonus babies, you had to stay in the big leagues.
Really?
Yeah. And then you go to the minor leagues. You know, how horrible would that be? You start at that age in the big leagues, and then, oh, by the way, you've got to go to the minor leagues now because you've spent your time that you have to here.
Interesting. Cano, Teixeira, and Abanez here in the top of the fifth inning. And that one's driven to center, and that's hit well. Crist going back, still going back, and it's gone. Cano answers right back, and it's 4-1 New York. You know what the great hitters do, try to explain this to the viewers, but they backspin baseball, and it just carries. And that ball had great backspin on it.
Well, he's just a great hitter. There's no doubt. And he's a year away from free agency. And guess who the next big signing second base is going to be? I mean, you think about it, and you're right. It's
kind of hard to explain, yeah, but it's that ball just keeps going.
Well, it basically spins in reverse because you get top spin. We talk about it, and it dies. Yeah. It just will die quickly. But the backspin, line drive, especially that way, it's going to travel.
So for Cano, his sixth home run of the year, and Teixeira, who homered in the third, steps in. Well, the Yankees have club options on Cano and Granderson for 2013.
And how quickly would they pick those options up?
So they'll be fine next year having both those guys. It'll be pricey, but they may have a decision to make. You sign them both, you sign one. This one's lofted down the left field line. A very long run for Seth Smith, and he goes into a slide. He can't get it. Bounces away from him. And Teixeira's heading for third. Smith's throw is there. They got it. Terrific play by Pennington, the shortstop, who had to cover third. Smith hustled after it. He made a nice throw. Boy, Pennington just had to hang in there.
Well, such a long run for Seth Smith, and a great covering of third by Pennington. But Seth Smith went in the slide, and then it kicked off his body. And then you figure it's going to be an easy triple. End of foul territory, but he hustled after the ball and watched the perfect throw. A one hopper to Cliff Pennington, tagged him in the chest as he tried to get in safely at third base. What a play by both Seth Smith and Cliff Pennington. So give him a double and a fantastic 7-6 on the putout.
I think Teixeira was surprised that he was thrown out.
Yeah, I agree. But that's a matter of Cliff Pennington. Of course, you think, where's the third baseman? But Josh Donaldson going out, and Pennington coming in quickly, thinking there's going to be a play. Didn't pay attention, but it's Corey Play. Corey Blazer, the home plate umpire, made the call, because third base umpire usually goes out, fair or foul.
So, Ray, we were talking about Robinson Cano. The fact that after 2013, he'll be a free agent. He'll be 30 years old after next year. But, I mean, he's probably a $200 million player, don't you think? Close to it.
Well, you saw what Ian Kinsler got, and Robinson Cano's got the whole package.
I think Robinson Cano, he's as good as any. He's an MVP candidate.
There's no doubt.
So if he's 30 when he hits free agency, 7-8 year deal to keep him. Between 20 and 25 million. I mean, it's a ridiculous amount of money, but
normally you wouldn't normally be saying that because he's a second baseman, but you look at what he can do as a second baseman, which is unusual. He's a great defensive type of second baseman, but he's a power hitter. Second, short, usually are not your power hitting positions. Number one, defense, and your corners being your power, but
and he's a gold glove. Oh, he's a gold glover, so.
And he's getting better and better defensively, but there's no doubt he's there, and the Yankees got to keep him. There's no way they're going to let him go.
I mean, so if you figure 20 million a year for 8 years, that's 160 million. But you don't, when you have the money that New York does, you do not let a guy that puts up numbers like that get away. It just doesn't happen.
Look at it, 300 average, over 30 home runs, 100 RBIs. I mean, that's a tremendous season.
That one's drilled to the gap. Nobody's going to get it. Bounces off the wall. Abanez with a double. He can still hit, folks. And he's 2 for 3 tonight.
It's a Cano with his dad pitching to him. Won the home run hitting contest in Phoenix last year. Last All-Star break. Dad, the house. How great was that? For his father there to throw batting practice to his son and to win the contest.
So three straight hits off Tyson Ross. He did get the out at third. So Swisher steps in. Abanez at second with the double. Swing. Action out of the eighth bullpen. Jerry Blevins starts to throw. 90 pitches for Tyson Ross. Swisher had a double in the second, a fly ball to center field in the third. Mention that Angels Mariners game. That's Santana for the Angels, Bevin for the Mariners. But Dan Aaron last night shut out with 14 strikeouts in game one of that series. So the Angels won game one.
Speaking of options,
yeah, that's right.
Just have a big one on there for a large amount of money.
I saw 15 million is the club option for Dan Aaron next year. Up to the club. It's funny, Derek Jeter's contract, he signed that 3-year contract. From what I read, Jeter really wanted a 4-year deal. He said, no, we're going to give you 3-year deal, but we'll give you a player option for the 4th year. Okay, all right. That's about as close as you can get to getting a 4-year contract. The old player option means if the player wants to play that 4th year, that's all he has to do is say yes.
Yeah, he will.
Up in the value deck. Authentic Fan Friday.
With signs.
Podcast Sportsnet tonight.
Authentic signs. That's pretty good.
Just graduated from school. That's a good effort. Enjoy yourself for a little while if you just graduated. Looks like a good crowd up there having fun. Swisher rolls it at the plate to even the count at 2-2.
We talked about Brett Bauer, who graduated from San Jose State University. The bat boy, he walks tomorrow. And he's talking to Joe Girardi. He said, Skip, I'm not going to be able to be here tomorrow. Joe said, what? He says, graduates, I'll be there. I don't think so. I think Joe will be here, Brett, while you're walking to get your diploma tomorrow. So, again, congratulations to Brett, San Jose State University.
He's a spark. Swisher got a hanger and he fouled it back. So a lot of pitches tonight for Tyson Ross as he's now at 94 with one out in the fifth inning. Side to Swisher.
That's a big elbow pad, but very close underneath, and his uniform's a little tighter than what we saw with some of the Tampa Bay Rays hitters that were glanced or at least nicked their bloused out uniform.
Two pitch to Swisher and a little emergency swing, and he was able to stay alive. It's not his best swing.
But you could protect and stay alive.
You do what you got to do.
So the two strikes you can make an emergency swing to get another pitch, then that is a good one.
Abanez is the runner at second. Swisher rips one down the left field line. That's hit pretty well. And that is gone. Swisher goes the other way. A two-run homer. And it's 6-1 Yankees.
Well, that emergency swing with two strikes got him another pitch, and he got him fastball, and we saw it here as a member of the Athletics, and now Swish comes back to the Coliseum. Tough for Tyson Ross. Those three runs in the third inning, how different it might have been without those, the unearned runs.
When it's time for change, think Speedy Oil Change and Tune-Up, your oil change tune-up and smog experts.
They've hit three. Teixeira, Cano, and now Swisher. So Tyson Ross, just 4 1/3 tonight. Six runs, three earned. All three were unearned in that third inning. So Blevins will take over. He faces Eric Chavez in the first pitch.
Well, the one thing the A's do have an abundance of lefties in the bullpen, and if you do have to go to the pen, and with the Yankees, they just have some switch hitters, but also left-handed hitters in the lineup. Good time to bring them out. Nick Swisher, after the breaking pitch that he fouled off, got a high fastball a little bit away, and opposite field power. He is capable, of course, hitting home runs from both left and right side.
Swing and a miss. Three pitches. Blevins gets the strikeout. So that's two outs here in the fifth inning.
Now the big sweeping curveball. Stay with it. And Chavez is not able to extend far enough to make contact.
Three home runs tonight give him 68 on the year. Only the Orioles have hit more in the major leagues. And the Orioles, too, they have the best record in the American League. Orioles won again, 8-2 at home over the Royals. Caught up by the scores and the heroes just a little bit. Justin Smoke just hit a two-run homer, so Seattle now leads 4-0 over the Angels in the bottom of the fifth. Angels have won three in a row, but they'll have to come from behind tonight.
And the start of the two wins here against the A's Tuesday night, Wednesday afternoon, 11 inning win on Wednesday afternoon.
Three and one now to Russell Martin. The walk. So Russell Martin is aboard for the second time. He's got a walk and a double.
Got a very happy grandson in Scottsdale, Matthew Mancuso, last day of school today.
Thanks.
So that's always good. And
kindergarten?
Pretty good ball player, too.
Well, I mean, surprised.
Had a home run down in spring training.
Uh-huh.
T-ball, blasted it, ran the bases. So congratulations, well, Matthew.
His mother and father, terrific athletes. His grandmother, a terrific athlete.
That's right. Just the genes in the family. So, Matthew, you got a great career ahead of you.
Oh, yeah, that's right. His grandfather was a pretty good athlete. Well, I saw him in San Diego a couple of years ago. And he was a big, strong little guy.
Right.
And I would imagine he's
getting bigger,
still growing.
That's right.
I think he and my son, Jack, knew each other for about 6 seconds, and I think they were sliding across the lobby floor in
right,
San Diego.
Right.
Lost all control in a very short period of time.
Yeah.
Good pitch by Blevins right on the outside corner. 1-1 to count. Jeter, one of the few Yankees that has had a quiet night. He's 0-for-3, two strikeouts and a pop out to first. This one toward Coco Crisp, but Coco got a good jump, makes the catch. Side retired. Couple of home runs for the Yankees, a solo shot by Cano, a two-run homer by Swisher, 6-1 New York.
Hey fans, you can bring in your game ticket and save 20%.
on Comcast Sportsnet California is brought to you by Evergood Sausages. Pick up Evergood Sausages at your local grocery store today. Beautiful look at the Bay Area on a Friday night. Now a little work to do for the Athletics. Still time. It's the Yankees 6 and the A's 1. Swisher with a two-run homer. Visiting some of his old fans out there in right field, I'm sure. So it'll be Donaldson, Barton, and Suzuki here against Ivan Nova. 6, 7, and 8 in the A's order. Nova's first pitch is at the knees for a strike. First place Rangers won tonight big at home over the Blue Jays 14-3. So Texas gets back to 10 over. They're now 28-18 on the year. Swing there by Donaldson behind in the count now 1-2. Donaldson struck out swinging in the second inning. He lines this one to center, and that's a base hit. Donaldson has a hit, and that's how the bottom of the fifth gets started. And here's our Subway Eat Fresh Ask Glenn and Ray question. Visit the A's page at csncalifornia.com to submit questions. Tonight, Terry Tyler from Grass Valley asks, why don't umpires have to wear helmets like base coaches do?
That's a good question. Of course, the helmets for the coaches just started maybe half a dozen years ago, and probably a good idea. And one of the reasons, you see, as the first base umpire is looking straight ahead. He's at first base. But I think a lot of times because the coaches are paying attention to the runners.
Yeah.
They have their back. And we saw Tim Flannery of the Giants. He actually was down the line. His back completely to the hitters. And of course, Mike Gallego, the third base coach, if he has a runner at second, he has his back trying to direct the runner at second base. Umpires are farther away from the actual action. But I think a lot of it, too, because they are looking right at the hitter. I mean, that's their job, to watch the hitter and watch the ball off the bat. And there are some home plate umpires who will actually wear the hockey style mask, which is a helmet essentially. But the old style mask is worn by Corey Blazer. It has the extension to protect his neck on any foul ball that might come up. It's the Steve Yeager invention when he got a bat hit him, protect his throat. But I think it's more than anything, they're just farther away, looking straight on to the hitter. That's my personal opinion.
Well, I think you're right. I mean, their job is to look at home plate. The coaches' jobs are maybe half the time to look away from home plate and look at the runners.
Exactly. And the home plate umpire is looking straight on, so if a ball hits, it would be off his mask, and hope that doesn't happen. But that will happen, and a lot of times the home plate umpire is protected by the catcher as he stands behind him. First happened, the first base coaches did not like to wear the helmets, but it's a nice rule, protection.
That's a good idea. Fair ball, pass to diving to Sharon down the right field line. Donaldson digging for third. Swisher gets it in quickly. They'll stop Donaldson at third. So Barton with the double, second and third, nobody out.
Well, you have to like the way the A's are trying to come back, and Greg Barton fouled off pitches and got to the point where he could pull the ball past to Shera, who was holding the runner. But as first basemen do, they will hold the runner, take out a couple of steps, and then in this case, Shera tried to dive back. The Gold Glover could not handle it.
Now batting,
and
the catcher
with the double,
number 8,
Donaldson,
the
third,
Suzuki.
And the A's at the point now, and it is the first opportunity they've had with the runner in scoring position. And now they have no outs, runners at second and third. And this is where they have to at least score both runs. They have to score both runs.
That's right.
No matter what, in this inning, they have to at least be three runs behind the Yankees by scoring these two. Yankees will play the infield back. If Suzuki gets a ground ball, they'd probably play the infield back for Pennington the same way. So these are gift runs that you have to get in the fifth inning.
Nova's first pitch to Suzuki. Breaking ball down and away, 1-0. Suzuki hit a fly ball to left field in the third inning.
Kurt knows that a ground ball to the right side accomplishes two things. It's so often said, but sometimes it doesn't always happen. And a simple ground out to the right side advances another runner to third and drives in a run. Even a ball on the left side. Donaldson should be going on contact with the ground ball to score easily.
Swing and a miss, throw, no. Saw Martin come up like he was gonna try to get Barton at second, but he held on to it. So now Kurtz got to put it in play down at the count 1-2 with Pennington in the on deck circle.
Palmer throws that big curveball that he features as one of his better pitches.
This one's driven left center. That's hit pretty well. Granderson on the move. Still on the move. And he makes the catch right in front of the Comcast Sportsnet sign. But it's plenty deep to move both runners up, including Donaldson crossing home plate. So a very productive out for Kurt Suzuki. And it's 6-2.
Also close for Suzuki in his first home run. Got a fastball, which was a shock to get that kind of pitch on a 1-2 from Nova. But Granderson, great speed, able to get back to the wall, make the play. And you just have to wonder if Kurt Suzuki, experiencing the pain in his left hand, is everything kind of top hand for him? Not much. Yeah, I think he felt he should have gotten enough, or maybe had gotten enough.
Pennington went after that breaking ball on the first pitch and he bounced it to Teixeira. So Pennington's not going to be happy. Well, it's really a pitcher's pitch, the first pitch you see.
And that's why when the pitcher throws a curveball first pitch and he gets an out, that's something that he's kind of maybe showing it as a purpose pitch.
It's foul gold, isn't it?
And it's just a swing. And really, if the ball is a second base, Barton's able to score instead. He rolled over. And it went to Teixeira.
So now it'll take a two out hit from Weeks. And that fastball is a bit inside. Ray Albert Pujols has just hit a 3-run homer. So the Mariners lead was 4-0. Now it's 4-3 in the top of the sixth inning up at Safeco Field. He hit it to right center. And that's a long ways. 2-0 now to Weeks.
All the critics that the first month and a half been all over Albert Pujols. They better start backtracking.
Well, he's got 20 RBIs in his last 19 games. That's not too shabby.
It's a matter of time. Like he said, I don't play 11 seasons in half the years that I did, and all of a sudden fall off the face of the earth and become a horrible hitter. Well, the high fastball, and Corey Blazer gives it to Ivan Nova, and not like he needs any help. So if a possible 3-0 to 2-1, makes a big difference.
Curve, and that's a strike. 2-2.
See, if it's 3-0, he doesn't throw that pitch. He might have him throw 3-1.
Coco Crisp waiting in the on deck circle. A run in for the ace, but they need to pick up this other run. Strike three called. So Weeks cannot pull the trigger. Strikes out looking, whips his bat and his helmet. A's gonna run. It's 6-2 after five. As a brand new insider, that's him right there. Blue shirt, tie. His name is Casey Pratt. Follow Casey on Twitter at CaseyPrattCSN. He's doing a great job. He started a week ago tonight over in San Francisco. So a week on the job. Greet him a couple times a day. He's doing a good job. So welcome Casey aboard. Working hard.
And I thought it was quite nice of him to say, as he is dressed up all the time. He said, "You guys keep showing me on TV, so I have to
that's right.
look the part."
It's good.
He looks the part. He's doing a great job. So happy to have him aboard.
Top of the sixth inning. And Granderson hits it toward Weeks. The short hop. Weeks was playing out in shallow right field, so Granderson is retired. Jamal Weeks a little frustrated with that last at bat. I think he was probably frustrated with home plate umpire Corey Blazer.
Now batting, number 13,
called three consecutive strikes in Weeks.
Rodriguez.
Wait. You don't want to get caught looking on three pitches with a runner at third, but Weeks didn't. Damn, I thought any of them were strikes.
Well, probably the biggest was the 2-0, and you know he's taking all the way, but does not mean it's an automatic strike. It was a high strike, and that kind of put him in a hole because two curveballs after that, both thrown and thrown for strikes.
Here's Alex Rodriguez with the shift on. Three infielders to the left side with Barton playing over what is a shallow second base. He's halfway to second base, Derek Barton. I'm telling you, it's the thing this year, Ray. We're seeing shifts much, much more than we did last year. So we could say 2012 so far is the year of the shift and the year of the injury. That's what. Who do we have today? Austin Jackson went on the DL.
The shift is okay. The injuries are not.
John Danks, White Sox left him. He's on the DL. So Danks and Jackson, two more good players. The DL. That one lined toward left field. On the move is Smith. He makes a nice running catch. So Rodriguez hit it right on a line, but Seth Smith got back there, reached up and made the catch.
Now batting number 24.
Well, we hope he is back soon. Yonis Cespedes. Nursing a sore left hand.
I miss him.
Absolutely. I think we all do. Of course, every time we see a team, Joe Girardi, they tell me about Cespedes. And everybody wants to see him play. Says some very good numbers for the young man in his short major league career.
Well, you looked forward to his at-bats because they were fun to watch. Swing and a miss by Robinson Cano.
Flipping sunflower seeds. Watch your elbows, guys. In the strange injury category, he's flipping sunflower seeds and something happened to the elbow. Pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds.
One and one to Cano, who homered in the fifth.
And your favorite device. There it is, taking a video of Robinson Cano.
Well, if that person had MLB TV, you could watch a game on your phone. Maybe not this one, but you could be watching the Angels and the Mariners. It's the blackout rule.
That's right.
Breaking ball that kind of stayed inside, but Cano chased it. 2-2 the count.
Corey Blazer almost called the previous pitcher strike. Started it with his shoulder. This one had to because it was swing and a miss on the emergency swing. Kind of a bring the hands in check swing type. But he went all the way through. Maybe looking for the pitch away as he did his last at bat when he hit the home run to center field.
Cano has also reached out a fielder's choice and reached out an error. So he's been on base all three times. Hard slider from Blevins with Cano holds up. So full count.
Well, Blevins slider slash curveball is so good. He can actually start it at the left hand hitter. That's how much it breaks. Starts at the middle of the plate. Cano just did. He recognized the break. Took it as it ended up off the plate.
So the payoff pitch from Blevins to Robinson Cano. Cued toward third. Donaldson has it. And that'll do it. So Blevins a 3-up, 3-down inning. We're headed to the bottom of the sixth. It'll be Crisp, Redding, and Smith. The Yankees lead 6-2. Light 6 inning, it's time for the Coors Light Freeze Cam. The Coors Light Freeze Cam is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. It's the world's most refreshing beer. Bottom of the sixth inning, the Yankees 6 and the A's 2. Nova will face Crisp, Reddick, and Smith. Pitch number 75 right there from Nova. At this point, you'd like to work Nova a little bit, maybe get into that Yankee bullpen. I mean, it's a good bullpen, but think of the guys that are not in that bullpen due to injury. It's a different sort. Labanez gets back and over to his left. He's got it.
Josh Reddick cannot see enough of these as Nova. And the pitch to Reddick just got under him. I can remember those. And a younger fan, at least a fan behind the Yankee side, able to catch it. Reddick has really done a great job. Got the WWF belt and got the right field faithful cheering for him. Albanez asked me playing left field tonight. I said, how are the fans in left field? Are they kind of the same fans? And I said, they're all the same.
Yeah.
They're all out there for you. Of course, reminded of Jeff Francoeur in right field and what he knew about the
Bacon Tuesday.
That Bacon Tuesday. Yeah. That's right. With the fans that he gathered when the Royals were in town. Bacon Tuesday. Who knows what Francoeur is going to do with the right field folks when he comes back again. That's left field. The same crew. It's always out there. Thin front and left field.
This one hit toward right. Swisher coming in. Do a dive and he made the catch. So Swisher takes a hit away from Reddick. And that's out number two here in the sixth.
Swish has gotten himself in great shape and he's hitting home runs as he's done tonight, making a nice defensive play. It's like the hamstring injury is okay. Lily married a year now,
yeah,
over a year, and said his wife's in town for the weekend. So Swish, you know, it's funny, he said it's great to get out of New York. And said it's just something about coming out to California. Of course, they're out here for a West Coast swing. The Yankees are. And finish up in Detroit. After here in Anaheim.
Yeah, this is a 9-game trip. Here, LA, and then there's race in Detroit. I think the Yankees are in a stretch starting tonight where they will play 15 of their next 21 on the road.
Just think of the crowds they will draw. They're one of the best drawing teams, at least in the American League.
And what you hope is you're one of the National League teams that gets them an interleague. They will go to Atlanta and to Washington this year. One and two to Seth Smith, who is 0 for 2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. That's strikeout number 4. So 6 in a row retired by Ivan Nova. Swisher is going to hit third. 6-2 New York.
Tigers game starts at 7:05. That's a big day for Kurt Suzuki and his wife Renee. Kidney Disease Awareness Day. $5 from each special level field level ticket will benefit the Kurt Suzuki Family Foundation, supporting scientific research of chronic illnesses and healthy living. Autograph items are also available. They'll be sold behind section 121 during the game and will benefit the foundation. For tickets, go to oaklandathletics.com or call 510-638-2205. It's always great to see players getting involved in the community and various organizations and foundations, and Renee and Kurt Suzuki top the list in that regard.
Teixeira to lead it off. Swings around, hit from the right side against Blevins. Two-run homer in the third for Teixeira, his sixth of the year. Career home runs for Mark Teixeira. He now has 320. Jim Miller starts to loosen up. This one's hit high and foul down the right field line.
Well, he hit seventh in the lineup a couple of days ago against Kansas City. The last time he hit that low in the batting order, he's hitting fifth tonight. 2003, rookie season with the Texas Rangers. He's come a long way. Rangers, Atlanta, Angels, Yankees. Great John Sterling, radio broadcast for the Yankees. Text message.
Yes, that's a text. Sends a text. Mark sends a text message.
Robinson Cano, don't you know? The Grandy Man can. He's.
Yeah.
John Sterling's got them all. Good voice of the Yankees.
A bomb for A Rod. I heard John Sterling on 95.7
yeah,
today, right? He was on with
right.
the guys.
That's
John
right.
Sterling, of course, the gentleman we're talking about. And they asked him about Melky Cabrera. Can you give us a Melky Cabrera? Well, he did it, but he wasn't quite as enthusiastic. The milkman delivers, I believe,
right,
is what
right.
he said when Cabrera was with the Yankees, as Teixeira strikes out.
Well, it should have had the previous pitch maybe called a strike. This one was, as a big sweeping curveball thrown by the lefty
now,
Jerry Blevins right in the heart of the plate, too. Mark Teixeira, and he knew it was gone. And there is John Sterling, the man right there. He is always dressed. See how he's got the tie? John Sterling, probably the only radio announcer I've ever known that wears a coat and tie
every game. I like it.
Yeah, it's class. He's dresses up for radio. He's had a big endorsement with his suit manufacturer
well,
for years. He's probably got them all in his closet. But why is he wearing them?
There you go. Hit hard. Pennington is there with the shift on. Abanez is retired. Two outs. Lovitz may have got a piece of that.
He's in the left field group. Beating the drums for Raul Banez. Actually, for Cliff Pennington for playing where he was.
Now batting. Number 33.
Oh, if you could only see. Look at them. Look at all the guys moving here. They move there.
I'm telling you, every batter they move.
That is amazing.
I mean, you watch Weeks and Pennington, and almost every bat, they're going back and forth, back and forth.
Can we use the guys in the left field bleachers and the guys in the center field? And maybe they call it to be green and gold. They're wearing the green and gold.
First pitch to Swisher is a strike, a double and a homer for Swisher. Swisher's closing in on a home run milestone. 193 career home runs, so seven away from 200.
Just have to wonder when Swisher was traded to the Chicago White Sox from the A's. And got Ryan Sweeney. Let's see. Fortino De Los Santos.
And Gio Gonzalez.
And Gio Gonzalez. If Ozzie Guillen had still, if he'd been down in Miami and been Robin Ventura, he might still be a White Sox. Ozzie just, the energy that Switch brings to the park every day, Ozzie just, you know,
sure,
that wasn't him. Just, but he really started out very slowly in spring training, kind of carried over to the season, and the best thing that happened to him was going to the Yankees, because he is, I mean, he loves it on the big stage, and he's changed a lot of the things in Yankees. He's been able to back it up. That's the key.
Chase is out of 0-2 pitch, so Blevins with a couple of strikeouts. He's done a good job. Seventh inning stretch from the Coliseum. The Yankees 6 and the A's 2.
He's trying to solve Ivan Nova. They got three more shots at the Yankees, trailing New York 6-2. A's with just four hits. They got a Reddick home run in the fourth. They got a Suzuki sacrifice fly in the fifth for their scoring. So Kaiahue to lead it off, followed by Donaldson and then Martin. First pitch curveball for a strike. Mariners still leading the Angels 4-3, bottom of the seventh inning. Kaiahue with a strikeout and a foul out. Nice play by Raul Ibanez down the left field line. Another curve stays outside. The Rays beat the Red Sox tonight at Fenway 7-4.
Chef Rodney getting the save.
Chef Rodney got his 15th save. Strike call looked like it was outside. 2-2. Man.
Another high strike, and Corey Blazer just, it's, no, it's a, an amazing strike zone tonight.
That one's drilled to right. Baby is gone. Kaiahue homer 6-3.
A no doubter on a curveball. What a great swing. The fastball away, and Nova, no doubt, likes his curveball, but a hanger. Max Scherzer, and now Ivan Nova. Watch this hanger and watch how quickly it goes out. That almost looked like his golf swing yesterday at Alamo Ground Hill. He's got a nice golf swing and even better baseball swing. That ball was crushed. It's a good golf.
Yep. So the A's keep chipping away. Second home run of the year for Kaiahue. 12 allowed already this year for Nova. Yeah, that is a lot.
Popped up. Teixeira into foul territory. Calls off Cano. He's got it.
Kaihua, what a great swing. He is always aggressive, and well, he had a little bit of a hamstring injury, but nothing affected him on that swing. Jumped all over the hanging curveball from Nova. What a great swing. Powerful swing from Kaihua. He knew it was gone immediately.
So Derek Barton steps in.
Think about the potential power of this Oakland A's ball club when everybody's healthy. I mean, there has been some, but so much more on the horizon whenever guys are able to get healthy and come back.
Barton 1-for-2 with a double. Swing and a miss, so it's quick 0-2. A's now with 39 home runs on the year. But you're right, chance for a lot more. Two pitch. You know, I think too, though, just as important as maybe getting some of the injured guys back in the lineup, which will certainly help. I think you could make the point that getting Weeks and Crisp going would be just as important.
Absolutely.
Because those two are struggling.
Yeah, you need the table setters, and that's what those two guys at the top of the order. Everybody's hoping that that will be the consistency that they bring. Once they get on base, of course, they could steal bases to get both of them in scoring position, or just to get on base in front of the guys who potentially are going to be able to drive them in consistently.
Barton with a base hit to left field.
But Tuesday, June the 5th at 5 p.m., it's the A's versus the Rangers. And one of those tweet up with the A's, and that's a special day that you're looking forward to on June the 5th. Special field level ticket includes early access to the Eastside Club, appetizers, non-alcoholic beverages, and Q&A sessions with A's players and the local media members. Tweet questions to @athletics using #athletics_tweetup. Tickets at oaklandathletics.com or 510-638-4627.
Here's Kurt Suzuki, who had a sack fly in the 5th, picked up his 14th RBI. So Kaihua, a home run here in the 7th inning to inch the A's a little bit closer.
Now Kurt Suzuki can still, I mean, that Comcast SportsNet California sign is good, but pull it a little bit down the line of the uptown scoreboard, and there's your home run. He's hit some loud shots this season. Either left center, right center, straightaway center.
That one sails right over his head. It rolls into the on deck circle. And Barton goes to second.
Did you see how close that came to hitting the bat of Kurt Suzuki? There's no doubt Kurt had to be shaken up just a little bit, especially see the curveball coming his head. Watch the bat. He brought it down, fortunately, just in the nick of time to avoid having the bat hit. That would have been a horrible foul ball, but that shot looks like it was not as close, but the other one definitely did. But Kurt, I mean, you don't know what to do, especially with a ball coming at your head. You know it's a curveball. You see the spin.
So a lefty and a righty now, Logan and Corey Wade. Larry Rothschild heads back. And they got a close eye on Nova now. So the crowd starting to get into it. A paid crowd tonight of 33,551. So not quite a sellout, but very close. Thank you. close again. 2-1.
And the Yankees are good and Soriano's good, but there's a guy named Mariano Rivera is not down in the bullpen waiting to come in to save a game. So that's a huge difference in a mindset for an opposing team. And the A's know that Mr. Automatic has had a tremendous career against the A's and everybody else, over 600 saves, but he is on the disabled list all season.
Kirk popped it up. Shallow right. Swisher comes in. He calls off Cano. He's got it for out number two.
There was a time you had to worry about Mariano Rivera in the eighth inning. Starter goes 6-7 and know that Bowl was available to pitch two if necessary.
Number two, Lance
not this year.
Well, that's part of that injury situation for the Yankees bullpen. Obviously, it all starts with Rivera, who's out for the year, but David Robertson is on the disabled list. Robertson, who was named the closer when Rivera got hurt, and he was having a very fine season. He's out. He's not out for necessarily a long time. And over here, Jabba Chamberlain is out. Michael Pineda, of course, the starter, is out. They signed David Artsma in the offseason, knowing that they probably wouldn't get Artsma back till maybe later this year. But Rivera, Robertson, Chamberlain, really the three big names in that bullpen. Pennington lost one. Shallow center. Cano out. Granderson in. Granderson makes the catch. Side retired. So Granderson ran a long ways. A's get a run on the Kaiahue home run. So we're moving on to the eighth inning from the Coliseum. 6-3 Yankees. Fitting. When it's time for change, think Speedy Oil Change and tune up your oil change, tune up, and small experts. It's going to be the right-hander Jim Miller coming on for his eighth appearance. He's got a win and a 1.69 ERA. He'll face Eric Chavez, Russell Martin, Derek Jeter. Miller last pitched on Tuesday against the Angels. First pitch strike. White Sox beat the Indians tonight 9-3 in Chicago. So the Indians, who just swept the Tigers, go to Chicago and lose. White Sox starting to play better. They've won 7 out of their last 8. All right. Two to Chavez, who fouls it back.
on a good fastball and slider, and we saw him in that start that he kept throwing the slider a little bit too far outside, but he's got a good one, a sharp breaker, and plus a load of mid-90s fastball. Young man who appreciates the big leagues and knows what it takes to try to stay here. He's had his trips back and forth to minor leagues. He knows it's a business, but see that he has the good enough pitches and stuff to stay here.
Jerry Blevins, how about his night? 2 2/3 innings. No hits, no runs, a walk, and 3 strikeouts. That's pretty good.
Well, after Tyson Ross left in the 5th inning, it's exactly what you want to see out of the part of the bullpen, and Joe Miller also a part of that, just trying to get the A's a chance to come back.
So 1-2 with Martin waiting in the on deck circle. Chavez reaches for it and drills it to right center. Reddick going back. He's going to have just enough room, and he makes the catch. Chavez just kind of reached for it.
And we saw him do that a lot and hit the balls into the seat. But this time, out on the front foot enough and just an upper body swing. Reaching with a pitch outside, trying to put it in the seats, could not quite make it.
The ball loose out in right field that Reddick picks up, flips back up into the seats. So Martin steps in. He has fouled out, doubled, and walked. 1-2. Rangers won tonight 14-3 over the Blue Jays. He scored 6 in the first and never looked back. Hamilton hit a home run, his 19th of the year. Pretty good night for Nelson Cruz. Nelson Cruz went 4-for-5 with a homer. 8 RBIs, and the home run was a grand slam. So the Rangers went big at home.
Well, that's at least 2. He hit one against the Angels in the weekend series where the Angels were in Texas.
Strike 1-2. Tigers beat the Twins 10-6. Good pitch there outside corner. So strike 3 called. So that's out number 2. Well, don't be afraid to vote for the 2012 All-Star Teacher Award. To do so, go to csncalifornia.com. Cast your vote. It's brought to you by the Provident Credit Union. It's the 2012 All-Star Teacher contest. So make sure you go to csncalifornia.com to cast your vote. That youngster's ready. It's your kind of guy right there, Ray, huh?
You know, he's an intelligent young man, too. He got the catching gear on. That's right.
Well, it's a holiday weekend for the youngsters. No school on Monday, so. Get 3 days off. Started off at the ballpark.
You know, that might have been, they had a kind of a chest protector backpack type of
thing. Yeah,
you know,
that's right.
Might have been it.
I think that was it. That was a couple of years ago.
That's right. But that is a smart young man. He knows exactly the position to be.
0-1 to Jeter. A little bit high. Jeter is 0-for-4.
I like the way the ball really jumps out of the hand of Miller. I mean, you got Russell Martin just. Martin started the swing. All of a sudden, the 94 mile an hour fastball is in Kurt Suzuki's mitt.
Curve spins inside 2-1.
Orioles won again. They beat Kansas City 8-2. Hamill the winner, Chen the loser. A terrific stat man BI gives us a good note, Ray. The attendance tonight in Baltimore was 28,954, which is a very nice crowd. Nearly 11,000 walk-ups. And that's a Camden Yards record. That is great. I'd like to see the attendance go up in Baltimore. The team is playing great. They're 29-17, best record in the American League. Gorgeous park, and they should draw well.
Weather is probably great, and that will enhance the people. Of course, winning does that. Yep. And you know, it's been such a drought for the Orioles to, in the postseason, have a winning season.
So that's the updated standings. Orioles and the Rays win. Blue Jays and the Red Sox lose. Yankees. See what happens here. Two and two to Jeter. Inside, Jeter struck out twice, fouled out to first, and flied out to center. Speaking of those Orioles, they signed Adam Jones to a long contract extension.
Out of time.
Yeah. So. That's good news for Baltimore as well. They're talking about a 6-year, $85 million deal for the Fine Center. He would have been a free agent after next year. And there's been a lot of talk the last couple of years about will they be able to sign him to a long-term deal. And they have done that. So it looks like Adam Jones is going to be in Baltimore for a while.
Should be able to get by on that.
He'll be all right. Yeah. Miguel Montero there. Fine catcher for the Diamondbacks got a contract extension today. 5 years, $60 million.
Thank you, Yadier Molina.
Jeter strikes out. He's 0-for-5 with 3 strikeouts. So Miller has a good inning. Top of the order for the A's. They trail 6-3.
Way.
Here's our team summary brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. 5 home runs in this game. 3 by the Yankees and 2 by the Athletics. It was Teixeira, Cano, and Swisher. Cano and Swisher both in the 5th inning. Swisher's going the other way. And then for the Athletics, Josh Reddick, stay hot. It's his 12th home run of the year, a solo shot in the 4th inning. Kilakaua hits his 2nd home run of the year. That was in the 7th inning, also a solo shot. So we have reached the bottom of the 8th inning. 6-11-0 for the Yankees. 3-6-1 for the Athletics. See 7 innings pitched for Nova. 101 pitches, and he is done for the night. So to the bullpen go Joe Girardi and the Yankees when it's time for change. Think Speedy Oil Change and Tune-Up. It's your oil change, tune-up, and smog expert. So Boone Logan comes in.
Just a two-pitch pitcher, fastball slider. Throw the two and four seam, but there's the four seam fastball. About 92.
Good season. Look at the strikeouts to innings pitched. So Logan can get the strikeout if he needs it.
He doesn't walk a lot of batters either, so that should help, especially time to pitch.
Granderson was playing very shallow. He comes in, he makes the catch. So Jamal Weeks is retired.
And we have not noted it, but we just saw it in what the Yankees outfielders do. They do play shallow, and Granderson in particular in center field. And remember, he was acquired from the Tigers, where he played in the massive Comerica Park outfield and did a very good job. That's a veteran now with the Yankees. And very shallow.
Yeah, that's for sure. And you know what? It's helped him tonight a couple times.
Yeah, he's, you know, you get excited. You see a ball that looks like it might drop, and the A's just saw Trout, and the Angels playing center field. He didn't run down a ball. And now with Granderson, good speed, but playing shallow, which makes it very nice.
First pitch to Coco Crisp is a bit inside. Coco is 0 for 3. Trying to get going. Right back to Logan, who reaches out, grabs it to first, and that is out number two here in the eighth inning. A's baseball at Comcast SportsNet California is brought to you by Roaring Camp Railroads. The further you go, the closer you get. Trains departing daily from the heart of the Santa Cruz Mountains. So two outs here in the bottom of the eighth inning. So Boone Logan has thrown four pitches and he's got two outs. Now he'll face Reddick. So Boone Logan, he's been with the White Sox. Spent a year with the Braves. This is his third year with the Yankees, and he's really figured it all out with the Yankees. He's become a very valuable part of that bullpen. 64 appearances last year, won 5 games. Called strike, looked like it was low. So 1-1 the count to Reddick, who homered in the fourth. Good fastball right at the inside corner. Brandon Lee trying to finish it up in Seattle. Mariners 4-3 lead, top of the ninth inning. Breaking ball, Reddick strikes out, and that is a quick inning for Boone Logan. He throws just 8 pitches, gets a strikeout, and finish off the A's.
Baseball on Comcast Sportsnet California is brought to you by Chevrolet and their award-winning cars, trucks, and crossovers, and by Jack in the Box. Right now at Jack in the Box, you can try the new Chipotle Chicken Club. Make it a combo with fries and a drink.
Top of the ninth inning from the Coliseum. Over 33,000 tonight in the house. Many will stick around for the fireworks after the game. He was trying to... If they can pull off a comeback, they will need to score a bunch in the bottom of the ninth. Granderson, Rodriguez, and Cano here at the top of the ninth. Jim Miller had a three up, three down eighth inning with a couple of strikeouts. Good curveball for a strike. There's the closer.
It's not Rivera, it's not Robertson. It's the guy they signed, gave him closer money before last year, and now he is the closer.
Rafael Soriano. Not a terrible backup plan, that's for sure. Fastball runs outside to Granderson, who has singled twice, walked, grounded out, and he has scored a run. Flips this one toward left center, shallow. Smith on the move, and he's going to get there. He makes the catch. So that's out number one. Here's our Chevron pitching matchup for game two of the series tomorrow afternoon. CC Sabathia and Bartolo Colon. So teammates last year, a couple of veterans.
13, Alex Rodriguez.
And that'll be 12:30. Get started with A's pregame line and then the ball game a little after one. So Sabathia and Colon in game two of the series. So here's Alex Rodriguez. Breaking ball down and away to Rodriguez, who is single, struck out, hit into a double play, and lined out to left. That one center field, the base hit. Went down and got it. So second hit for Rodriguez. That's 12 hits for the Yankees.
Just right back up the middle. Then low fastball. All Alex had to do was
Robinson
extend his arms and
Cano.
Not really try to pull the ball.
So Cano hits with a man on and one out. Cano is 1 for 4, and that one hit was a home run, his sixth of the year. The Angels have tied it up at Safeco. They have the bases loaded and nobody out. So they're trying to not only hit a blown save on Brandon Lee, but put a loss on him as well.
And they're trying to do to the Mariners what the A's could not do in all the games they've played, from Tokyo to Oakland to Seattle.
A's
have
the league.
A's would have a pretty good record if it was not for the losses against the Mariners this season.
Cano goes around on a high fastball, 0-2 the count. Soriano throwing in the bullpen. He will face Smith, Kaihue, and Donaldson. After Donaldson, it would be Martin. Norberto starts to throw for the A's. Post game live coming up. Conclusion of the ball game. runs. Pitch is high. Throw to second base. Not in time. Alex Rodriguez with a stolen base.
Now Kurt Suzuki with his head down. A strong throw, but just no chance. This does not steal as many as he once did. He's a 40-40 guy, but got a running start. And by the time Kurt Suzuki had the ball in his hand, Alex was pretty much sliding in. Made it a closer play than what it would seem. Got the hand on the bag. Plenty of time.
Well, he's 6-for-6 this year. He's a big guy, but he still runs pretty well for being in his mid-30s. So he can steal a base if he needs to.
You just don't see the reports that he's going to run as much. And it's an element of surprise. And plus you get certain guys with a high leg kick. And you combine the surprise element and the leg kick, and just not much of a chance to throw anybody in.
So 1-2 to Cano. Well, the Angels have scored two more. So the Angels have now scored three runs in the top of the ninth inning up in Seattle. And the Mariners have yet to get an out of that inning. So Cano gets a new piece of wood. Teixeira waits in the on deck circle. Rodriguez at second with one out. Yankees looking for some insurance runs. Pennington out. Smith in. Pennington calling for it. Now Smith comes in. He makes the catch. So Robinson Cano 1-for-5.
That's a big out, and have to get one more big one to keep Alex Rodriguez at second base. Three runs in. Tough to try to get against Soriano in the ninth inning, but at least it's three and not four, and that's the key. And try to keep it at three.
So Teixeira bats. He's 2-for-4. Got a home run and a double. On the double, he was thrown out trying to stretch it to a triple. Outfield fairly deep. Weeks out on the grass. First pitch and lines one into the second deck. Do not see a lot of foul balls go up that way. Up near Dallas Brayton Country Fair.
209. At 956.
Not quite. 206.
It's farther than that. 209 was hopping on Mother's Day 2010.
Yep.
First day of the 209 section.
There's Dallas. Trying to get healthy. It's been a grind for him.
Yeah.
One now to Teixeira. This was Dallas earlier today. He's working through it.
Not throwing it against the screen that protects the pitchers and got him out there all along.
Yeah. Welcome to the DL.
Yeah.
Huh?
Could field a pretty good team with the guys on the disabled list. Huh?
Yeah.
Several teams. Two starting pitchers right there.
So payoff pitch coming up to Mark Teixeira. Soriano still throwing in the bullpen. Teixeira. Oh, what a round. Alfonso Marquez rings up Teixeira, and we are headed to the bottom of the ninth. Work to do for the Athletics. They trail 6-3. From the Coliseum, this big crowd would like to see some action here in the bottom of the ninth. The Yankees with a 6-3 lead over the Athletics. And when it's time for change, think Speedy Oil Change and Tune-Up, your oil change, tune-up, and smog experts. It's the closer, Rafael Soriano, coming in.
Well, as we mentioned, it was Rivera, a closer, got hurt. Soriano, there with the Tampa Bay Rays, signed last year, 3-year deal with the Yankees. Closer money for a setup guy. Dwayne Wise takes over defensively in left field for Ibañez. And Soriano finally getting the opportunity to be the closer if David Robertson was the closer. Soriano, a couple of different fastballs. He'll throw the cut fastball and the slider. I guess if you're in the same bullpen as Mariano Rivera, you will throw a cutter.
But if you don't, you should. Smith trying to get aboard. Outside corner strike. Soriano is now 32 years old. 10th year in the big leagues. Soriano had the big season in 2010, his only season with the Rays. And he went 3-2 with a 1.73 ERA at 45 saves. That led the American League, and that got him the big contract with the Yankees. He's also been with the Braves, and he started with the Seattle Mariners. That's a nasty pitch, and Smith swings and misses.
Well, this is what happened in Kansas City. Royals hosting the New York Yankees, and a ball hit to right field, and Mariano Rivera went back and went down. And as Joe Girardi, his manager, said, anytime you see anybody, a player, grab his knee. And Alex Rodriguez, oh my God, as he looked down to see Mariano Rivera, Mr. Automatic, the closer, going down and disabled list. Out for the season, but boy, happy to hear him say he will be back next year. He had talked about maybe retiring after this season.
He's not going out like that.
No, no way.
I don't blame him. Kaiahue hits. Angels win it at Safeco. They score three runs in the top of the ninth inning off Brandon Leake. Final score, Angels 6, Mariners 4. So the Angels starting to put it together. They've won 4 in a row. They got a 3-run homer from Pujols tonight. Mariners cough it up late.
That's what you always like to see, those 3-run home runs. Earl Weaver is happy. That's all he went around for when he managed the Orioles. Just give me a 3-run home run. Bob Melvin would like to get a 3-run home run right now to get a couple of guys on a home run to tie the game. Down 3, and boy, those 3 unearned runs in the fifth inning, the third inning, that is, really stand out. Pass and runs and a couple of strikeouts. Like he might be able to get out of the inning.
Soriano flips to first, and that's out number 2. Remember, coming up after the game, A's post game live, and tonight we're going to have the A team, and that'll be Ray and myself and Ken and Vince from the radio side are going to come on over, and we're going to talk about tonight's game, and we'll do that during A's post game live. So join us for that. We'll have a little fun, break down the game. As always, we'll talk baseball with those two gentlemen, our good friends right next door. Vince Catrone on the left, Ken Korak on the right. They'll join us for the A-team coming up on A's postgame live. 2 outs. Here's Donaldson. First pitch, Donaldson goes around. Donaldson had a base hit, scored a run in the fifth. He also struck out and fouled out, so he's 1 for 3. Drills that one left center. That's hit well. Wise on the move, and he's going to play it off the wall. So Donaldson digging for second, and he's going to have a sliding double. So Donaldson keeps the game going. Starting to see some better swings from Josh Donaldson.
I got a breaking ball from Soriano. A hanging slider, just a one-handed swing, a line drive over Dwayne Wise, and fortunately, Josh Donaldson running hard, because this ball comes back very quickly to Wise. He knew it was going to be over his head, and a strong throw to second base offline. So that keeps the inning going.
So Barton will hit. Barton's had a good night. He's got a single. He's got a double. 2 for 3.
I think Josh Donaldson just hired you, Mr. Jeter. I don't know if if I read it correctly, but if he did, the captain might say, "What are you talking about?
Come on,
I'm not a Mr. Mr. Jeter."
Well, you know two things. You know you're really good. You know you've been around a lot.
That's right. He is both, and we just hope he stays around a long time.
1-0 pitch to Barton. 2-0. Barton's got to do absolutely everything he can to get on base, get the tying run to the plate.
Well, one thing for sure, we know Derek Barton will force Soriano to throw a strike. He has an excellent eye.
And that would call the strike on the outside corner. A's with 7 hits in the game. The Yankees with 13. There's been one error that was by the Athletics. Strike 2 called. Could have been outside. Barton goes for a walk.
Well, Martin on the outside corner, and I don't know how the overhead camera would show it, but Derek Barton used to have a pretty good eye. He hit a similar pitch to left field for base hit. And his last event, a double to right field, single to left. Big hole on the left side also.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that's the ball game. So Soriano comes in, gives up a hit, strikes out a couple. He gets the save. Nova gets the win.
And the Yankees take game one of this three-game series by a final score of 6-3.
Well, as I mentioned, it's unfortunate when you're playing a team like the Yankees or any team that has a very good team, you cannot make mistakes. And the Yankees are the type of team that will take advantage. They did tonight, and that turned out to be the biggest difference of the game. One mistake cost three runs, and the A's lose by three.
There's your final score. Once again, the Yankees 6 and the Athletics 3 in game one of the series. Well, thanks for watching Oakland A's baseball here at Comcast Sportsnet. It's part of the NBC Sports Group. Stay with us. A's post-game live with Henry Wilford and Greg Catterae starts after the break.